Today we're going to be talking about the extremely talented Yui Ishikawa. I mean, if you voice the most iconic anime characters of all time, like Mikasa, Ackerman, or Violet Evergarden, you're automatically goated. She also played iconic video game characters like 2B from Nier Automata, and even Enterprise, the main ship waifu from Azur Lane with the most iconic line of all time. On top of that, she has an insane catalog of her other supporting roles, such as Shigure Yukimi from Owari no Seraph, Miyoko Sahara from Silent Voice, China Kosaka from Gundam Build Fighters, and even Tomoe Takasago from Australia Parliament's favorite anime.
It's a Romanga Sensei.
This robust lineup led her to even winning the Best Supporting Actress Award at the 8th Seiyu Awards in 2014. So who is this extremely talented waifu? From cosplaying as your favorite character to singing your favorite OSTs. From looking hot in a professional photoshoot to being completely dorky on her Twitter. From playing an emotionless ex-soldier killer to being a 8-pack thick brick tsundere rock climber. Today we're going to be answering the question, who is Yui Ishikawa? Now, we don't know too much about Ishikawa's childhood. Like for real, her PR team be putting up walls around this chapter of her life that even Mikasa and the Survey Corps can't scale. But what we do know was that she was born on May 30th, 1989 in Hyogo, Japan. She joined the agency Sunaoko at the mere age of 8 and stayed with that company for 23 years up to 2019. She then decides to leave this agency for mid-management, and it's simply because she was at the same agency for so long that she wanted to see the world one step outside. I'm sorry, but is that a Attack on Titan reference? But I think the real breakthrough for Ishikawa was when she landed the Mikasa role for Attack on Titan in 2013. She even admitted in an anime interview that she wouldn't be where she is today if it wasn't for this role. Prior to landing the Mikasa role, she was actually focusing less and less on VA work, and even at one point, she thought about focusing more on her stage actress roles and even being a radio host. I mean, I don't really blame her hesitation because at one point, she was playing a squid. Now, I'm not going to get too deep on her involvement with Attack on Titan because judging by what you read as the title of this video, I want to talk more about the Kill Annie side of things. But if you do want me to do a balls deep report on her involvement with Attack on Titan, if this video gets at least 750 likes, I will jump on that video. But before we part with the Attack on Titan world, one thing I do want to bring up is during a show with the Attack on Titan cast, Ishikawa shared that if she was actually Mikasa, she would open a kebab store. And also, if she ever meets Mikasa in real life, randomly on the streets of Tokyo, the first thing that she will say is, and will be even willing to be Mikasa's love rival, even if it means her getting beat up. My homegirl is a goddamn G. Don't f*** with her, cause she gonna slice you with them Titan steel blades. Okay, now let's dive into the main topic of this video. Yui Ishikawa slash Kyo Annie. The best way to describe her relationship with Kyo Annie is that she's pretty much the adored daughter of that studio. Meaning that they're the perfect fit for each other, and Yui just seems so secured whenever she alludes to Kyo Annie Studios. There was this one blog post where she visited Kyo Annie for the first time, and she was straight up fangirling. She even went out of her way to purchase goods from their store, and even played some of that god-forbidden gacha. And of course, by the luck of the anime Kyo Annie gods, she was able to acquire a Violet pin. Honestly speaking though, if I was a A-list seiyu like Ishikawa, I would be posted up in the CEO's office, put my feet on the coffee table, and go like, okay, I want y'all to bring me every Miss Kobayashi Dragon Maid figurine you can find. Get on it. Oh god, I would make a horrible celebrity. But what really stood out to me during her visit was she was blown away by the work of the KyoAni staff. She states that so many people's feelings are packed into the projects before the final product is made. I have to work harder as a voice actress. I need to try harder. It's quite amazing to see talented people get inspiration from other talented people. I believe that is why Ishikawa is so good at what she does. And her humble attitude seemed like it carried over to other facets of her life. I mean, she was extremely nervous about hearing her results for the audition for the minor role of Sahara in Silent Voice. And when she landed that role, she recalled screaming internally because she wanted to look professional among her peers. I think her humble attitude and professional mindset is ultimately why the staff of Violet Evergarden approached her. During this pitch, what really stood out to her was the staff's enthusiasm of the project. Even though this project of course will be distributed in Japan, they were aiming for the big crowd, the international crowd. And even more so, they were looking for someone who's actually inspired to get involved in promotions. I think that initial pitch meeting made a lasting impression on Ishikawa and why she decided to go for that role. Well, she landed that role, and soon, Violet Evergarden will be her favorite character to date. She shares in the beginning of this role, it was pretty difficult because this character had no emotions. However, as each episode progressed, and as Violet started to connect with herself emotionally, Ishikawa added warmth to each progression. And her technique for showing more warmth in her voice acting is simply by raising the corners of her mouth more. And what she really aimed for was to make sure that this character felt alive. I mean, characters feeling alive was one of the countless reasons why Violet Evergarden absolutely killed the game when it first released. It's an understatement to say that Violet Evergarden became an international sensation and the pride of KyoAni Studios. Now, with everything amazing going on with Ishikawa's life and her name being synonymous with the seiyuu stardom, that amazing energy was also matched with some hardships. In particular, from 2019 to 2020, Ishikawa-san, for the better lack of words, went through some really shitty situations. Not only did she have to make the big adjustment of moving from her agency home of more than 23 years, just 2 months after KyoAni fires happened. And this was all going on while she was promoting the 2019 Violet Evergarden movie. And I'm pretty sure there was a lot going on in her mind, but she responded with a single tweet saying that, "I need you guys to promise me that you will be safe and okay." I think we saw more of her thoughts during a September 2019 premiere viewing of the Violet Evergarden movie. At this event, Ishikawa shared, "Violet Evergarden is really helped by a lot of staff. It was made with all of our hearts. I think there are many names in the end credit. Please watch it till the end. I would be grateful if you could return home, if you could remember those names. Only then will the spirit of everyone involved in Violet Evergarden will continue to live." Now, you would think that life would show my girl some mercy, but once again, she runs into another difficult situation. During May earlier this year, Ishikawa's agency had to file a police report because there was death threats against her. I don't even want to give this bastard any limelight, but this young 20-year-old got arrested early June 2020 by Kyoto officials. And what's even more f***ed up is while the son of a Rachel was posting death threats all across public message boards, he even alluded to the KyoAni arson attacks.
"Please kill me."
Oh god. I just hate humans sometimes. Honestly though, I really pray that you are at a much better place and that us fans will always support you from the sidelines. Now with all these videos, I love to end them with a direct quote from the person I'm talking about. This time around, I'll be sharing her closing thoughts after the Violet Evergarden anime season ended back in spring 2018. "By understanding your emotions, you will experience sadness and suffering that you have never known before. But with that same understanding, you can also touch the kindness and warmth of people." There were many things that were noticed by Violet's honest words and actions. I'm not very good at putting it into words, but I thought again that I should convey the important things in words. Meet Violet. I was able to play this character. I'm really happy. Thank you, Ishikawa, for giving us some unforgettable performances. We look forward to your future works for many, many years to come.